हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम यू ऑल इन दिस सेशन. एज यू आर अवेयरिंग, एज यू नो दैट इन प्रीवियस सेशन वी आर सॉल्विंग अ क्वेश्चन बाय डिसीजन ट्री एनालिसिस. एंड दिस वॉज द क्वेश्चन, इफ वी इन्वेस्ट इन अ प्रोजेक्ट देन फॉर पायलट टेस्टिंग, फॉर पायलट प्रोडक्शन टेस्ट मार्केटिंग यू नीड टू इन्वेस्ट 20 lakh rupees. आफ्टर दिस यू नीड टू take a decision whether if this step is successful, then you should go for investment, and the probability of successful is 0.7, the probability of failure is 0.3, right? So now once you are going for project, then the investment would be 150 lakh, otherwise you are not going for this particular investment, right? When you make investment, the probability that you would be having high demand is 0.6 and the low demand is 0.4, right? And you would be receiving 30 lakh rupees for next 20 years in case probability is high, otherwise 20 lakh for next 20 years if demand is low, right? So let us solve this particular question. Here we have to take a decision whether we should go for this particular project or not. So first of all, as I said, you need to start from right hand side and you need to move towards left hand side. So the first thing is you need to calculate the expected monetary value. The first point is expected monetary value at point C2, right? So this is your first step, expected monetary value here. So what is expected monetary value? It's very simple, just multiply 0.6 with this. Plus one more thing in this question is that you have been given interest, the discounting factor is 12%. So how to write this equation? Expected monetary value is 0.6 into 30 into what, you know, discounting factor is 12%, right? So you need to write present value this is present value okay let me write this this 12 into 20, right? Isn't it? You need to, because you are receiving ₹30 lakh for 20 years, and this is your discounting factor, right? 12%. So this is 12%, right? So 12% comma 20. Now this is annuity, right? So this value you can directly write from annuity table, plus 0.4 into what, 20 lakh, right? 20 lakh into, of course, similarly present value, interest factor of annuity is again 12%, and for 20 years. Now you need this particular value, right? And this particular value. So how to get this value? You need to look at annuity table, right? Yeah, so this is the annuity table. So rate is 12%, this one, and for period 20 years, right? So this is 20 years. So this value is 7.649, right? So 0.6 into 30 into, what is that value? 7 point, from this table, this value is 7.469 this plus 0.4 into 20 into 7.469, right? This will, this is 194.2, right? So this is the expected monetary value at this point, right? Now what is the second step here? You need to evaluate EVM, expected monetary value, at D2 point, right? Now since you know C2, you can easily calculate D2, right? So let's say expected monetary value at D2, right? So at this point there are two alternatives. This was the first alternative and this is the second alternative, right? So let's say alternative 1 and alternative 2, right? So the first one is, let's say D21 and D22, right? These were our alternatives, right? So since you are not going for this, so what is the expected monetary value? In second case it would be 0, right? And in this case it, what it was, you already calculated it, right? Which is 194.2 minus 150, because you are investing 150 million over here, right? So expected monetary value of D2 would be this 44.2, right? So we have reached at this point, okay, 44.2. Now the next step is, should we go for this decision or this decision? Naturally we will go for this decision, right? So we will truncate this particular decision, right? Now so the third step, we can say that we will truncate D22, right? Okay, now calculate expected monetary value at C1. So expected monetary value at C1, how to do this? It's very simple. Since you know what's the expected monetary value at D2, so 0.7 into 44.2 plus 0.3 into 0, right? This one, 0.3 into 0. So this is equal to, this is equal to this 30.9, right? Now we are at this point, right? So till this point we are getting 30.9 million rupees, right? Now let's see what happens at this point. You know that at C2 point we were getting 194 million, here we were getting 44.2 million, here now we are getting 30.9, and let's see what happens over here, right? So the fifth point is, let us find out expected monetary value at D1, right? So again there are two decisions. You have got, let's say, alternative, so D11 and D12, right? And expected monetary values are, for first, for D11 it is 30.9 minus 20, it is 10.9, right? Because you are spending 20 million in pilot production and test marketing. So whatever money you are getting here, this amount is to be subtracted from the money which you are getting from here, right? And second option is zero, right? You are not doing anything. So finally, what's the decision? Should you go for this project? Yes, you should go for this project, and you will have this much expected monetary value, right? So this is a very simple example on decision tree. We'll take up one more example on decision tree, and then we'll move on to some other topic. So let us look at a case. With the help of this case, we will be able to make a decision using decision tree analysis. So the case is very simple. There is an airline company which has to buy two types of aircrafts. In fact, it has to take a decision whether it should buy a piston engine aircraft or the other aircraft. The other one is turbo engine aircraft, right? So let me go through this case first. So the technical director of Airways Limited thinks that if the company buys piston engine aircraft which has got a cost of 1800 and has smaller capacity, but there is one more aircraft which is turboprop aircraft. Now the cost of this aircraft is 4000 and has a larger capacity. So when it has got a larger capacity, it will serve if the demand turns out to be high. But if you go for a piston engine aircraft, it cannot be used for higher demand, right? So the company believes that the chances of demand being high and low in year 1 are 0.6 and 0.4. So from the past data, the company has concluded that the demand being high and low in year 1 would be 0.6 and 0.4. If the demand is high in first year, there is an 80% chance that it will be high in subsequent years as well, and 20% chance that it would be low in subsequent years, right? The technical director of the aircraft company thinks that if the company buys a piston engine aircraft now, and if the demand turns out to be high, then they may go for second hand piston engine aircraft at the rate of rupees 1400 at the end of first year, right? This would double its capacity because they are going for second hand piston engine aircraft and unable to cope reasonably well with high demand from second year onwards. Now, apart from this information, the payoffs associated with high and low demand for various decision alternatives are shown in the tree diagram which I would be drawing. The payoffs shown for first year are the payoffs occurring at the end of first year, and the payoff shown for the second year are the payoffs for year 2 and the subsequent years, evaluated as of year 2 using a discount rate of 12%, which is the weighted average cost of capital for Airways Limited. So we have to take a decision what type of aircraft the company should buy, right? Should they go for turbo type or piston engine type, right? So before I start solving this question, let us look at what are the other payoffs available with this particular question. So we have to take a decision whether should we go for turbo prop type aircraft or piston engine type aircraft, right? So here we have to take a decision, right? So you can go for turboprop, or you can go for piston engine. When you go for this turboprop, what's the outflow? It's
minus 4000, right? And for this piston engine it is minus 1800, right? Now here this is your point C1 and this is another point, let us call it C4. In fact, first we'll branch this particular point. So when you go for turboprop, if the demand is high, then its probability is 0.6 and the amount which you would be getting is 1000 rupees. So this is high demand HD, let me write it like this, this is low demand, right, and its probability is 0.4 and the money which you are getting is 200 rupees, right. Now this is for first year, this is for first year, right. Now what happens in second year? Now this is C2 point, this is C3 point. Now in second year what is happening? This is second year, so you can have two options here. In second year we have been given that the demand would be high is 80% and it would be low is 20%, right, and this is the payoff for second year when demand is high and this is the payoff for second year when demand is 20%, right. Now if you look at C3 point, the demand is high again 0.4, low 0.6 and the payoffs are this 7000 and this is 600. So this is this is the decision tree for first option. These are different, you know, branches. Now when you look at the piston engine, then if the demand is high, which is 0.6, high demand HD is 0.6, right, low demand LD, I am writing it like this, so this is 0.4. Now when demand is high, this is your payoff. Now we have to, as I said in the beginning, we have to take a decision. Should we go for turboprop or piston engine type? If you are going for turboprop, you would be taking decision at the beginning and no further decisions would be taken. But if you are going for piston engine, then let us say if demand turns out to be very high in second year, then you need to buy a second hand piston engine aircraft, right. So this is a point which to be noted in this case, right. So this is D2 point, here we have to take a decision, right, and this decision would be taken whether should we expand it or we should not expand it, right. So when we go for expansion, so this expansion expand and this is do not expand, right, do not expand, right, this do not expand. Now this is C5. In C5, if the demand is high, again this is high demand, so this is 0.8 and 0.2 and the payoffs are this is 6000 and this is 600. If you do not expand, then this is point C6, you can have again high demand which is 0.8 and 0.2, right, and the payoffs are 2500 and 800. And if the demand is low, then this is just one more node over here, so high demand 0.2, low demand 0.8. In fact, it is not necessary that high demand
will always have higher probability, right? So the probability that the demand would be high is 0.2 and the demand would be low is 0.8, right? And these are different payoffs. So this is your decision tree for this particular example, and the payoff for this is 300. When you go for expansion, you need to incur this much money, right? Now we will calculate NPVs of different options. So let us first calculate NPV for this option, for turbo prop engine type of aircraft, right? And this is, as I said, this is the very first decision you have to make. No further decisions would be required in this case. So the NPV for this case is, you can easily calculate. So NPV, so the first one is NPV for turboprop is, you know, this is your outflow, so this minus 4000 plus. In the first year, the demand is high, so this is your payoff, demand is low, this is your payoff, right? So 0.6 into 1000 plus 0.4 into 200 divided by 1.12, right, which is your discounting rate, right? Now when you go for second year, you need to incorporate these values in calculation. So this plus, or let me write it here because we don't have sufficient space this side, so minus this plus this, now plus 0.6 into 0.8, 700, this 7000 plus 0.2 into 1000 plus 0.4. In fact, what we have done here is 0.8 into 7000, 0.2 into 1000, and multiplied by 0.6, right? Similarly for this portion also, right? So this 0.4 into this, 0.6 into this, multiplied by 0.4, right? So this is 0.4 into 7000 plus 0.6 into 600 is divided by 1.12 square, right? So when you solve this particular equation, you will get NPV is equal to 389. So if you go for this particular type of buying, if you buy this particular type of aircraft, this would be your NPV, right? Now let us look at this particular option, okay, piston engine option. Now if you look at, and as I have already said, in piston engine option you have to take one more decision after 1 year, right? So let us take first, let us calculate NPV for piston engine. So NPV for piston engine, first for expansion decision and for do not expansion decision. So for C5 node, and which is expand, we will expand our capacity, and the NPV is 0.8 into 6000 plus 0.2 into 600 divided by 1.12, and what is our outflow is minus 1400, right? So NPV is 2993. If you go for do not expand option, let us calculate what is NPV. So we will go for do not expand option. NPV is equal to 0.8 into 2500, right? This into this plus this into this plus 0.2 into 800, right? Divided by 1.12. So this is 1929. So out of these two NPVs, if you look at out of these two NPVs, you will certainly not go for this option, isn't it? Because this one is smaller than this. So what we have decided here, that will expand our capacity, right? And when we go for expansion of our capacity, this is NPV available with us, right? 2993. Now let us look at this option, right? Low demand option. So let us look at this option and find out what is the NPV. So NPV now is, so we are calculating third time NPV. This was the first time, right? This is our second time NPV we calculated for these two options, right? X1 and do not X. And third time we are calculating now, right? So the NPV would be now, since we are going for piston engine, this is our outflow. So this is minus 1800 plus 0.6 into 500 plus 2923. This is 2923. Let me check it once again. 2993. In fact, you need to check this value. So for the time being, let me keep it X, right? Now whatever is this value, just put it here. Plus 0.4 into 300 divided by, this portion is to be divided by 1.12, plus 0.4 into, plus 0.4 into 0.2 into 2500 plus 0.8 into 800, 1.12 whole square. Now when you solve this particular equation, it becomes 505. Okay, now out of these two options, should we go for turboprop type aircraft or should we go for piston engine type aircraft? We will definitely go for piston type aircraft because NPV here is 505. So this is how you can solve a question using decision tree analysis. So with this I complete this particular question. We'll continue with next point in this particular session. Thank you very much.